Hello. So, we thought we just started at the beginning and then discuss each photo for a little bit. So, what I wanted to talk to you about this photo is, what's the symbol? You know, it's called the new century. What is the new century about this photo?
Well, this is, they got the historic Serbian hat, the historic Serbian 4Ss, and the flags. And it's inspired by Delacroix's Lady, Liberty Leading the People. It's freedom. And she's pointing towards the east, where the sun rises. So it's the beginning of a new dawn. And she's young. And so it's the new century. It's the 21st century. It's a new century for Serbia. And so that's what that's about.
So we can continue to this lovely photograph. And this one is called Angels Fight for Us. So can you tell us a little something about this whole photo and where it was taken?
This is in this chapel next to St. Sava. And it was raining that day, so I ended up in there. And I was just putting on a tripod. People were coming in praying. But I was struck by this angel. Last year when I showed it, someone said, oh, I'm glad that angels fight for us because no one else does. And I thought, that's a wonderful thing to say, the angels fight for Serbia. So
that's a really good story. But we have this one, and it's called At Play. I really love this moment, and you capture it beautifully. So can you tell us something about the moment and where it was taken?
Well, this is Novi Sad, but the children you can see, not only here, there's a baby. They're playing football out here. They're watching, and just the wonderful activity. Of course, children are a big part of Serbian life, and I was just fortunate to catch some curious children.
Yeah. Childish innocence. Okay, so we can proceed to the next one. Okay, so I can just stand here. This one is called Mountain Stroll.
Yes, this was someone that we took up into the mountains in Serbia, and I can't even tell you where we were. It was actually very cold and windy, but it was very beautiful, and it was just a great moment. She reminded me of a Monet piece with the walking and the way the wind got her, and so it was a blue sky and clouds, so it was just a beautiful part of Serbia.
All right, and now we have this lovely, colorful photograph. It's called 22, which is obvious, we see why.
Yes, well, to American eyes, there's so much beauty in the buildings here because there's age and color and abstract content. And so it was just a beautiful thing to me to see from the worn to the new, just beautiful.
All right. Oh, and then we have this vivacious piece. It's called Dance For Me.
This is a multiple exposure. It's seven shots taken in one time, and I had the opportunity to be with the Gypsy Village all day, and they all danced for me, and this is in their dance hall, and I just stood there and shot some wonderful things. They were wonderful.
It certainly is wonderful. Oh, we have Still Standing. Can you tell us where this is taken? Because it's amazing.
This is Smedlevo, and of course, this is over 2,000 years old because this is Roman ruins that withstood very well until the World War II got blown up a little bit, but they're still standing right there on the Danube.
Thank you. Oh, okay. This is one of my favorite pieces. It's called The Bird Lover. So,
I wish I could show you all the shots. There are probably 500 birds, but they knew this man. And this day, it was probably -1 to 5 degrees. But every day you knew this man came out there and fed them. And you just see the wonderful beauty of them going up and down. And I never talked to him, but he knew I was shooting him. He was just having a delight with his birds.
And then we have this interesting piece. It's called Forward Motion.
Yeah, I was sort of inspired by Edward Hopper sliding in this one. There was just so much motion in the city at night, as there always is on the streets in Serbia. I just allowed the camera to run slowly, so we would just sort of get the blurs of people going by.
All right, and then we go to one of the, you know, people just know this piece. They love the face. It's called The Good Shepherd. So can you tell us the story about this photo?
Yeah, The Good Shepherd, of course, this man was 84 when I took this picture. We were driving through the mountains. And I jumped out of the car and ran across the field with my assistant and asked if I could take his picture. And he said, why would you want to? But it's obvious why. He's so beautiful. And he was working hard that day with his sheep.
Okay, thank you. And then we have sheep. Of course.
Different sheep than these sheep. This is at the oldest monastery in Serbia, and we went down there, and the monk was leading the sheep, and I just sort of fell in love with the sheep.
Okay. So we go to the other part of the gallery, and then we start with this one, and I love the name. It's called Heavenly Light.
This is the first year I was in Serbia. It was one of my earliest shots, and it just happened to be the right time of the day in the building where the light just hit the top of the wonderful temple there. Yeah.
So now we have this wonderful little girl, and this piece is called Hope for the Future.
Yes, of course, the children are the hope for the future, and this young lady, I asked her if she'd let me take her picture, and she was quite a ham. She said she wanted to be a model, but her grandmother called her back in later for dinner, and we were walking around the village, and then later, after her dinner, she came running back in a different outfit to shoot more, so she was quite energetic.
You can see that. And then let's start with the argument.
Argument again is the first year I shot. And I thought the irony, because there's a lot of arguments in Serbia of good spirit, but I thought it was funny to see that. And then it just shows everything. Even the trash is still in there. Just there's a beauty in all the colors and the reflections. So.
All right. And then we have identities.
Well, identities, just like everywhere in the world, everyone has names. And in America and Europe, we have different name tags with different names. When I just saw that, and I thought, oh, this is great. These are all the Serbian names, yes.
And then we are proceeding to a piece called Summer Flight.
This is shot on the Sava, and I stood there watching these boys jumping in the river in the middle of the summer. And fortunately, I caught him right there. We're shooting it, the sun down, into the sun, but it worked.
Okay. And then we have this piece called Mord.
Yes, this is on the Danube between here and Belgrade and Novi Sad. And I think those boats are still there, even though I shot that many years ago. But I don't even know what that growth is, but it was such a beautiful texture and coloring.
We're proceeding to a strong piece called Green.
This is a controversial piece. Some people don't like it at all. Some people love it the best. But I'm shooting it from the other side of a mountain, which was very high. It was, I don't know how high it was that we walked up, but I just saw how beautiful, green, and lush the valley was, and as there are many places like this in Serbia.
And what about the roadside beauty?
This is, I don't think I could find this again. I don't know where it was, but we got lost, and we had to stop, and I noticed the clouds were coming in a great storm, and then this wonderful feel in the house, so we were able to catch it.
So, okay, we're walking to my favorite pieces. This one is called The Winter Stroll.
Yes, this is the winter in Kalemegdan, and I live in the south. I never see snow. We don't much. And so it was really one of my early experiences of shooting in the snow and the magical properties of what it does to the images. So I was so excited to get that. And the same.
The Winter Quiet.
Yes.
A photo I love.
That's also in Kalemegdan, and I just looked down and saw it, and it was beautiful winter that winter.
And then we have the gate. Where is this taken, do you know?
This is invaluable, and it's a restaurant. In fact, someone has told me that there's great food there. I don't know, it was closed. This was Christmas Day, Serbian Christmas Day when we took it. So it was foggy and snowy, and it was just a wonderful shot.
All right, and now we have, okay, I'll just come here. Now we have the long road ahead. So I really love the feeling of this photograph.
Well, it's a long road because we're still walking up the mountain, and it was a long time till we stopped, but I just saw how beautiful that, you know, the mountains of Serbia are wonderful, and there's some great places you can go if you're willing to walk.
All right. And then we have the railside rose.
And this is right by the railroad. I don't know how it grows because there's a little house next to it, and it's exposed to the trains going back and forth, but I thought, well, here's this beauty propping up against this wonderful building.
All right. And now we have a red chair.
This is in a flea market. And we were just walking through the flea market, and I looked down and I saw the person had left their chair, and here's these beautiful calla lilies and all the wonderful plastic created an amazing texture.
And now we have a really, really interesting piece, and it's called From Where I Stand. So can we hear a little story about this photo?
This, From Where I Stand, as an American, is very important because if you look behind me, it's the building that gets pointed out to every American who comes here that NATO bombed. And so we were shooting from there across the street, and we were shooting with the slow shutter speed, and that's two buses. I think this took 2 minutes to take that picture. So two buses came and went while we were shooting it.
And we have one of the strongest pieces, in my opinion, and people seem to love it. It's called Past Memories.
This is a wonderful lady. She's a shepherdess. She and her husband, and they live in a home that's been three generations in their family, and that doesn't have water or power, and they don't come down from the mountain. But she was delighted to be shot, and then she held up the picture of her son's wedding, and her son had died, but this was a very meaningful thing to show this picture of her son. And she said, "Will I be in Hollywood?" Because I told her how beautiful she is.
Yeah. So now we have Peace Call Parked.
Yes. This is on the river, and you won't notice from perspective first, but this boat is a long way from that boat. It's down. It's down, but I was able to just get around it and get this amazing, beautiful textures, and it does look like that boat's parked against that boat.
And now we have an interesting piece called Winter Conversations.
Well, this was a very cold day as well on the top of the castle in Novi Sad, and I just love the yellows and the trees with the leaves still falling. It just created an amazing coloring, and so they were having a wonderful conversation. They obviously knew each other very well. So,
and now we have this colorful piece. It's called Abstract Reality.
Again, this is a piece that you don't see colors that are that beautiful in American homes or buildings. And my people that were with me that day, my Serbian friends, wondered why in the world I would want to see something like this. But it's so beautiful to me, the cracks, the squares, the fact that there's been a lot of stories in life in this piece. So
I think we discussed all the photos, and I just wanted to say it was a lovely exhibition and some lovely photographs and a lovely experience. So thank you so much for sharing your ideas and your thoughts with us and what you found beautiful about Serbia. So thank you.
Thank you.